Hey everyone, Valens here today with more mobile gaming. So today I did find this interesting free-to-play FPS for mobiles called Combat Squad. This is made into Unreal Engine 4, so we can expect good graphics, and it's also developed by Counter-Strike Online developers. For people who don't know what Counter-Strike Online is, it was basically a free-to-play Chinese version of Counter-Strike 1.6. But yeah, let's try to find some team deathmatch match, and then we'll check out the game. Okay, here we go. It has found a match. So let's choose our character, which later on I'll explain exactly what is that, but yeah. Let's try to snipe some idiot, and there goes my first kill of this match. What the fuck, where's everybody? Oh, shit. Ooh, shit, I missed that. Yeah, the sniping mechanics in this game are quite easily. It's quite easy to snipe because if you notice, there's some kind of auto aim. I mean, when aiming, you can totally see the sniper moving on the enemy. So yeah, that helps a lot because I've always found sniping quite hard in those games, well, for mobiles at least. But there goes a nice double kill also, and maybe a triple as well. Ah, shit. But yeah, as you can see from the graphics, they're made really really good. They totally look like Point Blank or some game like that. Not sure if someone has ever played that one. It's another free-to-play FPS for computers, but yeah. And this is not even the maximum graphics settings. In fact, I'm playing on high settings, so expect, I think, more high resolution textures on ultra. Are they camping on their spawn, or what the fuck are they doing? Oh, there goes a triple kill and a quadruple kill. Oh, this is going really good today. Honestly, I like this game. I did play it for some time the other day, and yeah, I did enjoy it quite a lot. It's also kinda addictive. I did play it for some hours straight, but yeah, it's a really good game so far. My favorite FPS for mobiles. Also, Ultra Key right there. Where the fuck did he go? But yeah, I almost forgot there's also this thing which is basically, if you press on that button, the A takes control of your character and does move and shoots for you. So it's basically one of those auto shooting stuff you see in the RPGs. And yeah, what was that? It was basically a selfie of the match. Yeah, it's quite a cool addition, I gotta say. I like that. But yeah, now I think it's time to check out the demolition game mod. Okay, here we go, it has found another match. It usually takes around 30 seconds for find one. This game is fairly new, so yeah, it takes some seconds for find one, but yeah. It's growing quite fast lately, so I expect to find the matches even faster in the upcoming days. But yeah, so as you can see, this thing does basically controls your character and moves around and even shoots for you. But I don't like it. I think it's quite trash because it will only get you killed easily. So yeah, I just go the manual way, which is the best. Oh, they already planted the bomb on my team, but yeah, first time to kill those guys. Well, if I'm even able to. What the fuck? Didn't I just reload and now I did that again? But yeah, what the fuck? This machine gun right there, it's quite trash. As you can see, it barely kills. I mean, I don't know. It took almost 3 mags for kill that guy. This weapon does fairly good in close range maps, but from long range, it's just shit. Okay, my team got the objective anyway, and we won. Nice, nice. Now I think I'm going back to try another gun. This is a quite nice weapon, but it has only 20 bullets per mag. So yeah, this is kinda crap, but yeah. Also, yeah, as you can see, this map is totally a dead ass statue. Not sure how to call it if. Yeah, this is just basically the dust do. You can totally see the map is the same thing. Well, besides the textures is the dust do, but with yeah, different textures. But yeah, just planted the bomb now. Let's wait. Oh, there was someone apparently there. And yeah, I'm playing with the auto fire activated. Wait, no, wait, what the fuck? Is he hiding behind there? Okay, they got him. They're rushing from long. Okay, we got that one and the two. Yeah. Well, the bomb is about to explode, and there goes our win. So far, 3 kills and 0 deaths. That's quite good. But yeah, as I was saying before, I'm playing with auto fire on, which only works for the assault rifles or the submachine guns. The sniper rifles, in fact, they don't have auto aim or auto shoot. So yeah, I do keep it activated because in this game it feels rather smooth and enjoyable, unlike some other FPS like Modern Strike Online. That one has a nice auto fire, but it's kinda trash. It usually stops firing a lot of times. I prefer it in this game, it's made better. Let's see if someone is camping over there. Oh, what the fuck? That's the whole team? Oh, nice! Oh, shit. Oh, double kill. Let's see if I can get the other guy too. Well, at least I did some damage to him. Ah! God damn it. What the fuck? Holy shit! Today is not my day, really. Well, at least we got that one. Let's see if I can get the last one too. Oof! I don't think I have time for it, and I don't have time. Yeah, round lost. But yeah, so far this game is good, but there's one thing I've never really understood about those Asian FPS. Yeah, because this game is made by a Chinese developer, as I said earlier before. But yeah, the thing I don't have ever understood is, are those games actually have multiplayer real-time battles or what? Also nice kill right there, as well a double. Because if you notice, the players don't move kinda strange. For example, look at this. This guy, when I'm not moving, he stops too. But when I start moving, he moves too. So yeah, I think this is rather weird. Maybe it's just some guy who's new at playing the game, but yeah, It sounds kinda odd to me, because I also noticed in the team deathmatch everybody kinda moves like in a bot manner. So yeah, I'm not sure exactly what to think, because wait a moment, let me kill that guy first. I can't concentrate while talking. Oh shit! Oof! Oh god damn it! Oh well, at last we got that one, and we lost. But yeah, as I was saying, holy shit, 9 kills, that's a lot. But yeah, as I was saying, I'm not sure if this is real time or not, because I don't know, guys. It just looks weird to me. The way people still playing to me, it just looks weird. To me, it doesn't really look like real time, but more like skill-based AI gameplay or something like that. I don't know. Talk about, for example, the Mortal Kombat X for mobiles multiplayer. Yeah, that kind of stuff, basically. Not sure exactly, but where is he? Ah, shit. I died. In a stupid way, too. I mean, what the fuck? Look at this. Why would someone, I mean, a real player, do, move like this? I mean, the enemies are behind there. Why don't you just go and kill them? I mean, look also at the way they move. I mean, I don't know. To me, this doesn't really look like what some real player would do. And now, why is this guy coming there? Well, we lost because my team can't play. Well. But yeah, honestly, not sure. Maybe the multiplayer's battles are real in real time, or maybe not, because you can invite your friends and play with them at the same time. But yeah, at the latest, your friends are actually real players, but unsure about the rest. Ah, well, I'll have to check. Anyway, as you can see on that red dot cycle with the number 1, this is where you access to collect your rewards for beating the daily missions or for techy elements, which can reward you with either the coins or the diamonds. The diamonds are basically the real money currency. So yeah. Then what else? First take a look at the options. Right here we have the graphics quality, which can go from lowest up to ultra. Right now I'm on high settings at lock at 30 FPS. The game plays and looks good. Here we can also modify the controls. So yeah, that's a good thing, since lots of games do miss this. Then what else? We have the language, which can be English, anything that's Chinese right there. Either Chinese or Japanese, not sure, but I think that's Chinese. Then here instead, in the squad tab, it's basically the place where you can make your squad if you have any other characters. And here instead, in the merch tab, you get to modify your characters' weapons or even apply the perks. First, I show you the weapons. You basically click on loadout, and there you can either equip your weapons or enchange them or even sell them. And yeah, you can also add stuff like pants, the vest, the headgear, which basically, it doesn't change the character appearance, but it gives you like more HP and armor. So yeah. Then there's the loadout, which here you can see all your weapons that you own. You can as well change them and stuff, as I said earlier. You don't really get all of these guns at first, only the MP5, but you can get them rather easily by going on the black market, which is this Basically here you have two cases, premium and normal. You get one premium every day and five normal cases. Now first let's start with the premium, which basically does always have the best gear or best weapons. And in fact we got a not so bad assault rifle, I'll check that later. And in the normal cases instead we're gonna get shit. Yeah, just shit. Let's equip this gun. Oh, it does. It's actually pretty good than the assault rifle I already had. So yeah, not bad. A nice case opening. And if you want to change a weapon, all you got to do is just click and change. And place your guns, I suggest to do it with the guns you don't use anymore, because by doing this you'll be losing them. And yeah, then you just press in change and spend the coins for upgrade it. It can vary depending on how many weapons you have placed. So yeah, this was pretty much the loadout tab and stuff. Then there's the perk. Perks are basically abilities which, for example, the purple one, this one, this gives you the ability to defuse or even plant the bomb faster, and this one instead reduces the damage from primary weapons. There are also many other perks, but you have to unlock them first. And if you want to equip this perk, you need to go to your merch tab. Click on each character and spend the currency for the equip, one of them, which basically is of 5,000 credits. Okay, then what is left? Oh yeah, there's also... this game has Google Play game support. In fact, you will unlock achievements and it does also save your profile online, so yeah. The game does also have a friend list for play with your friends, as I also mentioned earlier before while playing. So here there's also the shop, which you don't really get to buy guns, but so far just the characters. There are two with credits and two rest are with diamonds, but yeah. You can also buy the packs of diamonds as well as gold packs, which do have well, golds, and they're purchasable with the diamonds, which, as I said, diamonds are the real money currency. What to say? Oh yeah, the game modes. As you can see, there are three tabs. The first is practice, which basically are missions against boots, which I recommend playing one or two before jumping into multiplayer. Then there's Shadow League. What is Shadow League? Basically, you get to fight a guy against another player squad, but it's not controlled by him, but by the computer, so yeah. Then there's also, obviously the multiplayer, which is the core of the game. And we can see that there are the Team Deathmatch, the Demolition, which is the mod I played before with the bomb. Then there's Annihilation Mission, which is basically the Demolition but without the bomb. Then there's also the Zombie Match, which I have yet to play because there aren't any people on it and they can't find a match, sadly. Then there are also Team Deathmatch, Demolition and Annihilation 1 versus 1. And if you click on invite friend, you can invite your friend and search up a game. You can invite up to 9 friends. So, also I forgot, the game does have a running event promotion that if you download the game and play it until the 7 May, that already passed. But yeah, basically, if you launch the game, download it, you get some bonus. In fact, you get golds, diamonds, And the green sniper rifle I used before, the AWM, which is quite good. So if you have yet to download this game, do it, because that sniper rifle is really good and you can get it for free. So yeah, this was pretty much it. This is Combat Squad. My honest thoughts is that this game is worth playing, and it can be a serious, really competitor against Modern Combat
Shadow
versus
Gun Legends.
Versus.
So, what guys, I leave the links in the description for download this game. And yeah, I hope you have a good fun with it. This game deserves more recognition.